Anxiety disorders, what you need to know. We all get a little anxious sometimes, usually when we're in a stressful situation. If you've ever started a new job or had to speak in front of a large group of people, you know the feeling. But what happens when the source of stress doesn't go away and the anxiety just sort of clings on to you? When feelings of anxiety get too severe and unreasonable, that's a sign they've crossed into disorder territory. Anxiety disorders are relatively common, affecting roughly 30% of adults at some point. Children, of course, also suffer from these issues, but often go undiagnosed and cannot get help on their own. Just because anxiety disorders are common doesn't mean they're fun, or that their impact on our lives should be minimalized. Just the opposite. They can have pretty serious effects on us when we experience them. So we need to understand and address the problems that anxiety disorders create in our lives in order to move past them. The first step is defining the disorders. Let's start with the most commonly diagnosed version, generalized anxiety disorder, or GAD. Here, the person faces persistent, excessive worry so extreme that it literally disrupts their daily activities. They sit and worry. Their racing thoughts get them all tensed up, to the point that finally that inner turmoil comes out as physical symptoms. Pretty soon, they may feel fidgety, have a stomach ache, muscle tension, headaches or migraines, or just sheer tiredness from all that stress slowly wearing them down. As you can see, it's no picnic. GAD can drive some people to strive for perfection, which may not seem like a bad thing. But it can be if it interferes with their work-life balance or makes them focus on one thing while everything else falls apart around them. And GAD is only one type of anxiety disorder, so let's classify the rest. The National Institute of Mental Health lists panic disorders, which can lead to those infamous panic attacks, causing the sufferer to then worry about having another panic attack. Phobia-related disorders, such as intense fear of blood, flying, or heights, leading to avoidance behaviors. Social anxiety disorder, which, in a nutshell, is like extreme shyness that creates severe inner distress. Selective mutism, a relatively rare situational disorder where the person can't talk around certain others. Separation anxiety, which often affects young kids who worry about being away from their parents. And agoraphobia, the fear of things like being in a crowd and being away from home. The Department of Health and Human Services also adds obsessive-compulsive disorder, which causes sufferers to overly worry about things like germs. It can often drive them to perform unusual, ritualistic behaviors, such as excessive hand-washing. And post-traumatic stress disorder, which all too often gets labeled as a combat-related disorder, when in fact anyone can suffer from PTSD after a serious ordeal. For many, these anxious feelings are so uncomfortable, the person tries to numb the pain through substance abuse as a form of self-help, instead of seeking treatment from a trained professional. Unfortunately, self-medicating with alcohol or drugs can quickly lead to dependency and addiction, creating a spiral as the anxiety and substance use issues create what's called a co-occurring disorder. All of the above types of anxiety disorders are effectively treatable and can be relatively simple to diagnose by a medical expert. The first step to feeling better is making that decision to get on the road to freedom from anxiety. Now that you know more about anxiety disorders, take comfort in knowing that Imperium is on your side to help restore your confidence and quality of life. Call or register with us today, and let's get you the help you need. Follow us on social media